Dudes, Matt Cameron. The Godfather, the one. Matt made his bones as drummer for the inimitable Soundgarden, and went on to fill the drum chair of the band that was arguably Soundgarden's biggest rival, Pearl Jam. In today's lesson, however, we will be going back to 1994 and breaking down three iconic drum beats from Soundgarden's record, Superunknown. I'll show you what they are, I'll play them for you, then I'll break them down. And we'll have everything transcribed for you. Dudes, stay tuned. So guys, before we get into the lesson, quick reminder, everything that I talk about in this lesson is going to be transcribed for you. To download that transcription, just click the link below the player. You'll be good to go. So we're going to start the countdown at number three. The number three Matt Cameron beat on Superunknown is a song called Head Down. First, let's hear Matt play it. Now let's hear my attempt at imitation. And now, let's break down how to play it. So, we're going to cover the Head Down track in three discrete parts. First, we're going to talk about the pocket and the general kind of choreography you want to have with your body to be able to play this and make it groove, because it's not intuitive and it's easy to make it rush and feel antsy. Next, we're going to talk about the meter and how that affects things. And finally, we're going to talk about the resolution points writ large. So to start off with, I'm going to give you a beat in four that'll make it easier for you to practice this without worrying about the meter or the resolution points. And that's just this. Three, four. To make that even simpler, let me play all the tom parts on the hats so you can hear exactly what the different parts are doing. So, three, four. Let me play just the first half. So, you'll notice I've got two very soft notes and two accented notes. That's the kind of ghost note undercurrent Matt's keeping that you want to keep so that you make sure you groove through this. So again, the full beat in four is three, four. Now let's talk about the meter. So if we think of this in a slow four, so one, dun, 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 three, four, and two, three, and. Then the subdivisions are 16ths, and the phrasing is, it's three bars of four and one bar of three. So let's roll tape of me playing that. For those of you guys who are worried you're going to get lost, I'll remind you, this will all be transcribed so you can read it. But I want you to hear it first. Whenever I look at a chart or a written music with just a ton of odd meter and I don't see any resolution points, it's really hard to play. So that's why it's the resolution points that make this song come alive. And Matt constructs his entire beat around those. So our first resolution beat is on the and of beat four in the first bar. So remember, our generic beat was three, four. So in the spot where I played that tom note, Matt's either going to catch a cymbal usually or a cymbal together with the snare. So three, four. The second bar, there are no resolution points. So you're basically just playing groove through that. So if we play the first two bars, three, four. And there's no one set pattern that Matt plays through that. He just improvises. But you're playing around with kind of a theme and variations of the thing we did in the first bar. So in the third bar, we have a resolution point on beat four. Then in the following bar, the last bar, the bar of three, we have a resolution point on the upbeat. So that'll sound like three, four. Ba, ba, da, bum, four, one, and two, three, back. So when we play that, three, four. Let's roll that part of me playing it with the recording. And now let's roll that whole recording of that entire phrase. That was a breakdown for Matt Cameron's beat from the song Head Down. For our number two, we have something that's super popular, super well covered. I'm speaking, of course, about Spoon Man. Let's first listen to Matt Cameron play it. And now, here's my feeble attempt. Next, I'll break it down. Oh my god, you guys, so Spoon Man is the quintessential example of a simple but not easy beat. The intro is literally a classical, like, bass drum part. But the point is, it has to be nailed. And at this tempo, I guarantee you, if you try this two or three times, record yourself, listen back, you will be rushing. Let me show you how it goes. Three, four. So the accents are important. The outline is three, four. You're essentially playing along with the guitar player and the bass player. But listen carefully for the accents there. Three, four. Ba-da-da-da-da-ba-da-ba. Anyway, you get it. They'll be transcribed for you. You can check them out. Let's run me playing just the beginning of that with the accents again. So next bit is incorporating the snare backbeat into this. And here's how it goes. Three, four. Easy way to learn this, just think about it in four. I'm gonna give you a dummy four beat, and then we'll learn the longer phrase that Matt actually does. Three, four. So he's interspersing the kick drum with the floor tom. Let me play the floor tom parts on the hat so you can hear what's kick drum, what's hands. Three, four. Now let's talk about the time signature. It's in a slow seven. Da 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 da. So when you play the full beat, you're going to take that first phrase of four, but then the second bar is a bar of three, which goes like this. One, two, three. So putting them both together, three, four. The other thing is at the beginning of every phrase in the verse, you have to catch this. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-ba. They feel the rhythm while they something. One more time. Finally, the chorus is in four, and I believe that Matt is just playing on the bow of the ride cymbal. It goes like this. So that part's easy peasy. This will be transcribed for you. Please enjoy. So folks, that was Spoonman. Next, you're probably wondering, what's the number one beat? Is it The Day I Tried to Live? Is it Let Me Drown, perhaps? No. It is a sleeper. It's a song called Kickstand. And it's actually two bar phrase out of that song. Let's roll the tape of Matt playing that. Now, let's hear my pale imitation. Finally, break that down for you guys. So in Kickstand, we find one of the most underrated two-bar phrases in drumming and rock music combined. Let me play this at full tempo, and then I'll slow it down. Three, four. Now, let me play it slower, and let me play it with drier sounds so you don't get completely washed out. Three, four. So let's break it in half. The first part is bam, ba, da, yo, bong. That's the guitar phrase. So the drums are going three, four. Two, three, four. And of course he's hitting the crash cymbal. Three, four. Two, three, four. But he does this really interesting, delicate thing on the hi-hat in the second half of the groove, which I can only imagine is sticked like this. Three, four. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. A really dazzling display of cleanliness and finesse, which just indicates to me he's got deep fusion roots. He's not just a basher. There are so many. Anyway, I won't get off on a tangent. So let's put the whole thing together. Three, four. The other thing you're going to learn when you play this along with the recording is going to rush. In fact, half of the real learning in learning to play this beat is learning the choreography, then playing it with the recording, then discovering your way off from the band, adjusting, and finally getting that feeling when you nail it and it's difficult. Anyway, that's how you get the gig. So dudes, I hope you've enjoyed this breakdown of my three top Matt Cameron beats from the Soundgarden record, Super Unknown. Do you agree with these beats or not? Leave a comment below. And just a reminder that if you want to download the transcription, that's available for free if you click the link below the player. I've got two versions, one in which you get a 3-video free gift from me, which will help improve your drumming and I don't share on YouTube. Another, where you say, nah, I don't want to get better at drumming. And you just download that transcription free and clear. Although I don't know why you wouldn't want to get better at drumming. Do you? Anyway, dudes, it's been real. Always enjoy these. See you again soon in another lesson of the week.